Welcome. If you've clicked on this video, you're probably aware of how to join copper pipes through either soldering or, for a stronger joint, brazing. And that takes skill. Well, ever since I've got this 4-in-1 2000 kilowatt laser welder, I have been told and was advertised that you can weld almost any sort of material with it. This is me welding steel. And so I've never really tried copper. So I decided to start off with, let's see if we can weld some copper pipe. At this time, I don't have the wire feed on. And it just seems like the laser beam sometimes melts the material, but then almost gets either absorbed or reflected off the material. And I just could not get the material to even to melt or start to puddle. So I struggled with this probably 5 or 6 times. After that, I decided to turn the wire feed on. And the wire feed I have is actual stainless steel wire. And the stainless steel wire, I'll post a picture up right now, it's like a 308L. For MIG welding, and I've been using it a lot for actually stainless steel welding with this laser. And the shield gas I'm using is nitrogen. So I also know that they were advertising that you could weld to similar materials with this laser. So out of just curiosity, I turned the wire feed on, and the laser, as soon as the wire feed started feeding into the laser pool, it started to actually melt the copper with the actual stainless steel, and producing a weld that was actually as easy to weld as any other material I've welded with this, like steel and stainless steel. So that was pretty neat. I'm using a Vevor rotating welding fixture that I've put a old lathe chuck on. It's only advertised to hold 5 kilograms, but I've definitely put more on that. This is really easy, or makes it easier to weld rounder pipes and tubes, things of that nature. Lets you get a really nice weld. Now, after I weld this, you'll see that some of it was kind of, this is just me first time welding it, and it was kind of a struggle to see. The contrasting colors to the mask weren't as definitive as, say, steel or stainless steel. So my bead definitely could be, from appearance-wise, improved. But the neat thing with this is it welded it. And there was probably a good half inch of weld that looked really nice. The other could be improved, but it was welded on there. Now later you'll see me pressure test this. So the idea with this is, okay, how can I hook up my air compressor to this tube to see if it could hold pressure? So I decided to get a air compressor fitting that is brass, thinking, okay, well, I could probably weld this if it's dissimilar metal too. As you see here in the video, it did not go well. the well just did not connect to the actual brass at all. So now I found a old piece of basically cap that was off a tap off of a copper to Romex that I had lying around, and I'm just gonna butt weld this together. Again, I was having a hard time seeing the, where the basically the line was where the two pipes joined to get a good bead on how I was going to weld this. So it definitely was not a great setup, but even with it being offset and janky, I was actually able to get a good weld on it. And a couple times I actually punched a couple holes in the actual copper and was able to just to fill it in just like you would weld any other type of material. Here, I totally missed the joint, so I had to go back and re-weld where I missed the joint. So this weld definitely wasn't a nice smooth weld, but it held pressure, as you will see later in the video. It's not gonna win any awards, but it is two pieces of copper pipe welded together with stainless steel wire. Here I'm pressure testing it to about 60 psi, and the only reason I'm doing it to about 60 is the fact I have this, piece of rubber tubing in between the regulator and the pipe that is only really rated for about 16 psi. So I didn't really want to overpressurize that piece of rubber tubing. But after I pressure it up, I have some of the soapy water in this rag, and that first joint that welded the 3/4 inch right here that I'm testing right now with the rag, I didn't have any leaks whatsoever. The second joint with the butt weld, I did have one little pinhole leak that you could barely see, and I just went right over it later and just took about 10 seconds to fill in that pinhole leak, and it was good to go. So I'm really impressed of how this could do this. Subscribe. I have a kind of a crazy idea on what I'm going to do with this. Basically welding something that's stainless steel to a copper. And if you haven't seen my other videos, I've used this 4-in-1 laser welder to cut, clean, and weld all sorts of cool stuff. So make sure you check out my channel, subscribe to keep up to date, and thanks for watching the video.